Hey everyone, it's Duncan Epping, yellowbricks.com, and today I've got something really cool to show you. And this basically is the integration between vSphere DRS and vSAN that VMware has introduced as part of vSAN and vSphere 7.0 Update 2. As you can see, we've already created a stretch cluster configuration, and I've created two distinct locations with host 75, 78, 87, and 77 as part of my secondary fault domain. I've also already provisioned a virtual machine, which I have provisioned to the secondary fault domain, and I've made sure that it actually keeps on residing in the secondary fault domain by creating VM and host groups, and of course a rule as well that states that my Photon virtual machine should always reside in my secondary fault domain. Now, if my four hosts that are part of my secondary fault domain are going to fail, vSphere HA is going to restart that particular virtual machine in the preferred fault domain because I created a shoot rule. So the virtual machine is still going to be restarted, even though I've created these rules. Now, the interesting part here is the following. Normally what would happen is, because we have these rules in place before 7.0 update 2, what would automatically happen is that as soon as the host would return for duty, that particular virtual machine would move back automatically to the location that the rules specified that it should be residing in. Now, starting with 7.0 update 2, vSAN and DRS actually communicate to make sure that it waits until all of the resync has fully completed. So the data of that virtual machine needs to reside fully in both locations before DRS actually considers moving back that virtual machine. So we just had the virtual machine failing and failing over, of course. And now what we're going to do is we're going to log in to the virtual machine to basically create a file to ensure that we have some data that needs to be synced between those two locations. So from the preferred location to the secondary location after the secondary location returns for duty. And then hopefully what we will see is that after the resync has completed, is that DRS is going to move that virtual machine back to the location that it should be residing in based on the rules that we've created. So let's create this file. We're going to create a file of around 10 gigs, so there should be a significant amount of data to resync between these two locations. So we just created the file, or we started the command to create the file, and now we're going to switch back to vSAN to server to see if we can actually figure out which virtual machines have been impacted by the failure and if those virtual machines need to resync or not, because that information, of course, is available in the HTML5 interface. So we can click on resyncing objects, and that will immediately show you that there are a number of virtual machines or objects that need to be resynced. In this particular case, it states that 13 objects need to be resynced. And now when the four hosts will return for duty, that resync process will automatically start. So vSAN is going to automatically take care of that. As you can see at the bottom half of the screen, a couple of virtual machines or objects popped up, and it's actually resyncing the data. So when I refresh the UI, I will actually be able to see that the bytes left to resync is going down. So it states 9 gigs, or now it states 7 gigs and 6 gigs. As you can see now, it says 5 gigabyte, 4 gigabyte, and the number just keeps on going down. As soon as the total amount goes back to zero, the virtual machine that still resides in the preferred location should automatically migrate back to the secondary location as specified by my DRS rules. So as you can see, the resyncing has just completed. So let's click on the virtual machine to see if we can actually see that switch happening from the preferred location to the secondary location. Now note, this is going to be a vMotion. So it's going to live migrate from one location to the other location based on what we specified in the rules. And as you can see, here we go, the virtual machine is already migrating back, so DRS has detected that the resync has completed, and as a result, it can move the virtual machine back to where it belongs. With that, we've reached the end of the demo. Thanks for watching. I hope you found it useful. Make sure to like the video and subscribe to my channel.